Welcome to BS Zelda, which is short for Broadcast Satellite View Zelda No Denzetsu. I've lost track of how many times I've said this because I've had to re-record it so many fucking times. I'm your host, as always, the Cold One, and if you don't know this, get out of here. I say that almost every single time, but, you know, its meaning does not lose, is not lost, does not lose. Yes, I know English grammar good. Alright, so, I am playing this. This is an enhanced remake of the original NES Zelda, Legend of Zelda. It has two types of characters. Link, which, you know, he has a dong. And, I'm just gonna call her, what can I call her? I'll just call her Boobs. You know, like I have here. And Link and Boobs, they're your heroes. And since I got this ROM from Chibi Fighter, and it is her birthday today, I will be using Boobs, and her name will be Chibi. Because, you know, Chibi's awesome. She gave me the ROM, it's her birthday, and I promised I'd do something special for it. But for now, we're just gonna go in, get our sword. I have no control over that. You're made to do that. So you can't do a swordless run. But here's how it's gonna work. I'm going to take this sword and shove it in this old man. I can't get behind. I'm gonna shove it repeatedly into this old man. No. Here's how it's gonna work. I'm going to clearly label in each video what I'm going to be doing in each video. Like, say, I'm going to be going to the first dungeon in this video and completing it. Yes, I know, it's kind of obvious that I'll be doing that. But I'll be going to each dungeon, completing it, etc., etc. So, this first video is going to be labeled Dungeon 1. And this is where I get my arrows for the bow. Why did they spread them apart? Even in the original game, they spread them apart. It's stupid. Who packs a bow but no arrows? I'm getting ahead of myself. Yes, I am getting far ahead of myself. Talking about the treasure that I'm going to be getting. I sort of went off on a one-track. Well, not a one-track. How does someone with a one-track mind lose their train of thought? But anyway, I'm heading towards level 1, or dungeon 1, whichever you want to call it, and that's what this video is going to be named after. Item collection videos will be, you know, labeled item collection videos, and will be most likely set to music, unless you want to hear the conversation. Yes, I'm going to be having a conversation with myself. Unless you want to hear the commentary on those boring-ass videos, tell me. I'm willing to listen. But yes, as you can tell, enhanced remake. I'm not gonna go in this door over here, because that's just an old man who tells you that arrows cost money, and that's a waste of time. And speaking of time, as you can see in the upper right hand corner, there is a timer, yes, but certain items are only available at certain times of the hour. I know you'll get some people saying, oh, certain items are only available at this specific hour and this specific minute. No, it doesn't work like that. Every single minute of every single hour, you know, something special happens. Or, not really something special happens, but, something new becomes available. And every now and then, during the course of time, you'll get something like infinite bombs, a powered-up sword, or a boomerang that can kill shit. Or is that the super magical ultra boomerang? Oh well, it doesn't matter. And I'm going to be killing these little dippin' dots, because they're awesome to kill. But they give you no prizes, which really sucks. Oh, and in here, I get my bow, because, you know, it's just awesome like that. And, yes, I know exactly, almost exactly where to go in just about every single room of this dungeon, because I've played it so many fucking times. If I remember correctly, it's like every 10 or 30 minutes that something special happens. Like I said, I haven't gotten no bombs. I am kind of scared that I've gotten no bombs this entire time. But, like I said, I'm gonna be chill during this. Unless, you know, I get pissed off, which is, you know, a prerequisite. I sound like Mushmouth. A prerequisite for just about any game that I play. And every time the minute changes, you're going, ooh, bombs. I got bombs now. Bombs. You want them? No. I refuse to say that now. Yeah, but I keep losing my train of thought. Every single time I get to saying something, I get hit by an enemy. But, yeah, I get the feeling that I'm going to be getting very pissed during this because, you know, that's a prerequisite for any game that I let's play, that I get pissed. Which is hilarious to some people. It's not hilarious to me because, you know, it pisses me off. But, I'm just fucking dipping dots. That's what they look like, dipping dots, but gooey. Maybe jelly beans? I could go for some jelly beans right now. That would be awesome. Ooh, two on one go. Killing these things with bombs is much faster than killing them with a sword. But oh wow, we're almost at the boss of this dungeon, and I've been talking for a little over 5 minutes, because you know I had an intro going there, but, and here we have the Wall Masters, named because they came out of the wall in the original Zelda and not from the ceiling like Link to the Past in Ocarina of Time. And here's the boss, the dragon, everyone knows it. Wow, those actually home in on you pretty damn well. But, I win. That was easy. It's always fun to kill that thing with bombs. And I fail at walking in a straight line. I have not yet mastered this tedious, hard task. And here we have the first piece of the Triforce. It doesn't show it in the dungeon, but I'll show it as soon as I get out. And that's it for the first dungeon of Broadcast Settle of View Zelda. Fun game, I have to say, and it looks very nice. Now then, that was my first piece of the Triforce. As you can see, it's, you know, 8 pieces. Conveniently labeled like a color by number. But, yes. I will see you guys next time on Let's Play Broadcast Settle of View Zelda. Tell me what you think of this. You know, tell me if you like my chill commentary or my fake enthusiasm commentary, which is so much fun to do. See you guys next time.